Hello everyone, welcome to our online class, grade 7 maths chapter 1 integers part 3. Today going to discuss about properties of addition and subtraction of integers. First of all, see the property, closure property. Closure property under addition. We have learned the sum of two whole numbers is again a whole number. For example, 17 plus 24 equal to 41. 17 is a whole number, 24 is a whole number, and answer 41 is also a whole number, which is again a whole number. We know that this property is known as the closure property for addition of the whole numbers. Let us see whether this property is true for integers or not. Following are some pairs of integers. Observe the following table and complete it. Statement 1. 17 plus 23 equal to 40. Result is an integer. 17 is an integer, 23 is also integer, and answer 40 is integer. Sum number 2. Minus 10 plus 3. Minus 10 plus 3 equal to minus 7. So minus 10 is integer, 3 also integer, and answer will be in integer. Check the remaining sums. What do you observe? Is the sum of two integers always an integer? Yes, the sum of two integers always an integer. Since addition of integers gives integers, we say integers are closed under addition. In general, for any two integers a and b, a plus b is an integer. Once again I repeat this. In general, for any two integers a and b, a plus b is an integer. Closure property under subtraction. What happens when we subtract an integer from another integer? Can we say that their difference is also an integer? Yeah, of course. Observe the following table and complete it. Statement 1. 7 minus 9 equal to minus 2. Result is an integer. 7 is an integer. 9 is also integer. The answer will be in integer. Check the second statement. 17 minus half minus 21 equal to 38. So 17 is integer, 21 minus 21 is an integer. The answer 38 is also an integer. Check the remaining statements. The result is an integer or not. What do you observe? Is there any pair of integer whose difference is not an integer? No. Can we say integer are closed under subtraction? Yes, we can see that integer are closed under subtraction. Commutative property under addition. Commutative property under addition is a plus b equal to b plus a. Let's check for the example. A is equal to minus 65 and b is equal to 23. So a plus b, minus 65 plus 23 equal to minus 42. Right hand side, b plus a, 23 plus of minus 65 equal to minus 42. Both left hand side and right hand side are equal. So a plus b equal to b plus a. Commutative property under addition is true for all integers. Try this with 5 other pair of integers. Try this with 5 other pairs of integers. Commutative property under subtraction. Commutative property under subtraction is a minus b equal to b minus a. For example, a is equal to minus 12 and b is equal to 13. Left hand side, a minus b. Minus 12 minus 13 equal to minus 15. Right hand side, 13 minus of minus 12 equal to 1. So a minus b not equal to b minus a. Left hand side is not equal to right hand side. So commutative property under subtraction is not true for all integers. Try this with 5 other pairs of integers. Try this with 5 other pairs of integers. Associative property under addition. Associative property under addition is a plus of b plus c equal to a plus b plus c. For example, a is equal to 6, b is equal to 2, and c is equal to minus 7. Apply the value in the associative property. So a plus of b plus c, 6 plus 2 plus minus 7. Solve within the bracket first. 2 plus minus 7. Comparing the two numbers, the 7 is a greatest number. The sign is negative, so the answer will be in negative. 7 minus 2 is 5. The greatest number sign is minus, so put the sign in minus. 6 plus of minus 5, you get 1. Next, right hand side. A plus B of plus C, 6 plus 2 plus minus 7. 6 plus 2 is 8 plus minus 7 equal to 1. So the left hand side and right hand side are equal. So A plus B plus C equal to A plus B of plus C. Associative property under addition is true for all integers. Associative property under subtraction. A minus of B minus C equal to A minus B of minus C. Let's check with example. A is equal to 6 and B is equal to 2 and C is equal to minus 7. Apply the value in left hand side. 6 minus of 2 minus of minus 7 equal to 6. Solve within the bracket first. 2 minus into minus plus. So 2 plus 7 is 9. 6 minus 9 is minus 3. Next we going to apply right hand side. 6 minus 2 minus of minus 7. 6 minus 2 is 4. Minus into minus plus. So 4 plus 7 is 11. So a minus of b minus c equal to a minus b of minus c. Associative property under subtraction is not true for all integers. That means left hand side equal not equal to right hand side. A minus of b minus c not equal to a minus b of minus c. So associative property under subtraction is not true for all integers. The last one, additive identity. When we add 0 to any whole number, we get the same whole number. 0 is an additive identity for whole numbers. Is it an additive identity again for integer also? Observe the following and fill in the blanks. First one, minus 8 plus 0 equal to minus 8. Minus 23 plus 0 equal to minus 23. 0 plus minus 59 get minus 59. Minus 61 plus 0 equal to minus 61. And check the remaining statements. The above example show that 0 is an additive identity for integer. You can verify it by adding 0 to any other 5 integer. In general, for any integer a, a plus 0 equal to a, and 0 plus a equal to a. Chapter 1, exercise 1.2, question number 1. Write down a pair of integer whose option a, sum is minus 7, b, difference is minus 10, c, sum is 0. Solution for a. One such a pair whose sum is minus 7, minus 5, minus 2. So add the two numbers, you get minus 7. Minus 5 plus minus 2 equal to minus 7. The next pair is minus 10 plus 3. Minus 10 plus 3 equal to minus 7. Question number 2. Option A. Write a pair of negative integer whose difference gives 8. Solution for A. Write a pair of negative integers whose difference is 8. Minus 2, minus 10. Minus 2, minus of minus 10 equal to minus 2 plus 10 equal to 8. So likewise, minus 5 and minus 13 gives 8. Check with it. So remaining two sums is homework. Okay students, let's do the homework. Exercise 1.2. Sum number 1, option B and C. Sum number 2, option B and C. Sum number 3 and sum number 4. Homework chapter 1, example 1, exercise 1.2. Sum number 1, subdivision B and C. Sum number 2, subdivision B and C. Sum number 3 and 4 fully. Okay, students.